we're gonna be building our own tiny plant worlds. And because ours are self-sustaining, you won't ever need to water them once you're done building today. Are you ready to build?
Yeah, let's do it.
Welcome to STEAM Workshop, where we explore science and art through awesome projects. I'm Julia, and I'm one of the product designers at KiwiCo. Can you tell me your names?
Yeah, I'm Sophie.
And I'm Gabriel.
Hey, Sophie and Gabriel. At KiwiCo, we really like building things that help us understand the world around us. Do either of you know what a terrarium is?
Yeah, so a terrarium is sort of like a little habitat for plants.
Yeah, that's a great description. So it's actually all in the name. Terra is Latin for earth. And then if we smush that together with aquarium, we get terrarium. So today we're gonna be building our own tiny plant worlds. And because ours are self-sustaining, you won't ever need to water them once you're done building today. Are you ready to build?
Yeah,
let's do it.
All right, let's take a look at our materials. So we'll need a clear container with a lid, some small rocks or pebbles, some activated charcoal, potting soil, plants, and of course, water. Some other materials that are helpful but optional are a spoon, a paintbrush, and some decorations. So our first step is to remove the lid and add some rocks. We want just enough to cover the bottom of the container. So can you guess why we're starting with a layer of rocks on the bottom?
Maybe to let the water, so when the water gets absorbed through the soil, it will go out into these rocks, and these rocks will prevent it from, or will allow it to have some space to like evaporate.
Have you ever left your laundry in the washing machine too long, or stuffed a wet raincoat in your backpack and forgot about it?
It started smelling bad and had some mildew in it, and then we had to clean it.
Yeah, exactly. So since we want our terrariums to last forever, we're gonna prevent that by adding drainage. So our next step is to add the activated charcoal. And this can get a little dusty, so make sure you add it carefully. And again, we want just enough to cover the pebbles.
It smells like barbecue.
That's because people do actually use charcoal for barbecue. Have either of you used activated charcoal before?
No, I haven't.
Well, you might have actually used it without even knowing, because it's in a lot of different water filters. It filters out all that nasty bacteria and fungi to keep the water nice and clean. Do you have any idea how activated charcoal, which is basically just burnt wood, can do that?
No, but I've been to a restaurant where the pitcher of water has a big stick of charcoal in it.
Yeah, exactly, that's a water filter. So the way that that works is that charcoal is made of carbon, and all of that carbon attracts other carbon things. And because bacteria and fungi are living, they're made of carbon too. So the charcoal attracts all of that living stuff that's gonna make everything rot away from the water, but it lets all of the important minerals and nutrients like sodium and nitrates just pass through.
Cool.
Okay. Ready for the next step?
Yeah.
Can you guess what goes next?
Dirt.
Yes, okay. So we're gonna want to add the dirt in carefully, because this soil puts the dirt in dirty. And we wanna make sure that there's plenty of soil, because that's where our plants live. So we wanna give them a nice comfy home. Perfect. So next in our terrarium, we're gonna put plants in. Sophie, can you explain to me how we should transplant our plants into the terrarium?
So you take a plant and you sort of squish the sides of the pot to loosen the soil. And then you can just start sort of trying to squeeze the plant out that falls into your hand.
That was exactly right. So we've taken our plant out, and we're gonna dig a little hole, but not too deep because we don't wanna punch through the charcoal layer. And we're gonna take our little plant and put it in. And once it's in, we're gonna use our spoon or our fingers to gently pat the soil around it to make sure it's nice and secure. What's your favorite plant of the ones you have?
I don't know. Probably this one because it has nice leaves.
Oh, that one does have nice leaves. I agree. What about you, Gabe?
Yeah, mine's probably this one.
Oh, that one has cool stripy leaves.
Yeah. Wow, actually, it's different colors. There's like the darker green and this like coming off this like the middle of the leaf, and then there's light like it's stripes. There's like a smaller leaf inside.
Ooh, the leaves are pink.
That one's called Hypoestes. So we chose little plants that like a lot of humidity since they're gonna be kind of trapped in the self-sustaining terrarium with lots of water vapor. Can you show me your terrariums? Ooh, nice. Those look so good. Are you ready to decorate?
Yeah.
So the decorations that we have today are some ceramic mushrooms, as well as some mini dinosaurs. This is your terrarium. You can put whatever you want in there. If you have other rocks that you've been collecting at home, or shells, or other mini toys that won't rot, ooh, pterodactyl, you can throw those in your terrarium. I think I'm gonna put this dinosaur in because I really like how the dinosaurs, since they're so many, they look like they're walking around all of the giant plants that used to exist during dinosaur time.
I'm gonna put the triceratops right under the mushroom where it's getting shade.
That's where I'd wanna be if I were a dinosaur too, under the giant mushroom umbrella.
Just chillaxing under a giant plant and giant mushroom.
Can you show me your terrariums?
This is my terrarium.
Ooh, those look awesome. Are you happy with them?
Yes.
All right, our last step is to water our plants. So we're gonna use our fingers to mimic rain to introduce the water. So we're gonna dip our fingers in the water and then flick it onto our plants. And we're gonna do that 10 times.
Raining!
I like the feeling that I'm controlling the rain with my hands.
It's also hot.
Yeah, and the water's pleasant. The dinos are getting wet. Take shelter into their giant mushroom.
I just hit a raindrop up beneath the horns on the triceratops.
I know it doesn't seem like a lot of water, but since these plants are so small, they need just a tiny bit of water in order to keep going. But can you guess how much water one of the biggest plants on Earth, the California redwood, can drink in a single day?
2,000 gallons.
500.3 gallons.
It seems like you already knew that fact because the California redwood can drink 500 gallons of water in a single day. And that's about 1,000 times what you and I drink in a day.
Wow, that was so close.
Yeah, did you know that fact already? That was incredibly close.
I actually didn't, I just shouted out a random number and then a decimal.
I am thoroughly impressed, Sophie. All right, the last thing that we need to do is put our lids on our terrariums so that the water can cycle endlessly, just like on Earth. Do you know how the water cycle works?
Yes. When it rains, the water is then collected in streams and rivers and the mountains. That flows down to the oceans or lakes, and then in those places, the water evaporates into water vapor, and then the water condenses and forms little water droplets, which forms clouds, and then when the water droplets get heavy enough, the water droplets rain and fall down back to Earth, and then the cycle repeats.
Again and again and again. So this is basically purified dinosaur pee.
I had never thought of it that way before, Sophie, but I will never not be able to think of it that way now. All right, let's all put our lids on. Are you ready? 3.
Cue the black and white. Editors, get the black and white and horror music.
2. 1.
Okay, dramatic musical.
So we've made our self-sustaining terrariums. Congratulations. So what'll happen over the next few days is that the water that's in the soil and down by the rocks, it will evaporate and then it will condense on the top and the sides of the jar. And then it will drip down like rain and the process will continue forever.
And ever.
Well, if you want your plants to last forever and ever, you should put your terrarium in a place with a lot of indirect sunlight. So that would be like by a window, but indoors. Because if you put your plants directly in the sun, you're going to cook them, which is not what we want.
Fried plants coming up.
Thank you so much for building a self-sustaining terrarium with me. I had such a good time and I can't wait to see your terrariums in 50 years. See you next time.
Bye. And make sure to leave a like and subscribe.
And share your comments and opinions below.
Great, that was awesome. Oh, and we add the dab at the end.
You have to put this in the video because I will be watching it.
Yes. We will watch it.
Dab!
We want to see your terrariums too. Ask a grown-up to share a video or photo of your terrarium on Instagram and make sure to tag @KiwiCo_Inc. And for more projects like this, go to KiwiCo.com.